Very good morning all of you. Today we will see transmission line theory. This is first topic in microwave and radiating system course. And before going to the topic, we want to know why we need transmission line theory. So if you take any transmission that happens in the two wire, we connect the signal and we observe the output at the load, and there is no change in the output, it follows the input, it's simple transmission line. In the low frequency, the time period is larger because time period is inversely proportional to the frequency. When our frequency is lower, time period is more. So in the load point, there is even it's taking all signals will take finite time to reach the destination. The time we call as transit time, the time taken to reach the destination. So when it's take finite time to reach the destination, since it's a longer period signal, there is a slighter change in the signal. So the, for example, the point, starting point is P, is little bit shifted to the right side. The finite delay will be there for all the circuits, but it is unnoticeable for a longer period signal. It's nothing but low frequency signal. The same case, if I take high frequency signal where our time period is very small, when time period is small because the frequency is higher, the time period is smaller, so it reaches the destination with transit time TR, and it is, there is a delay, so there is a difference now becomes very apparent. So the same two wire line, when you send low frequency and when you send high frequency, so there is a difference. So the difference comes because of there is a high frequency signal and there is a lot of voltage current is going to change in the line before reaching to the load. So this is particularly, it is also particularly valid for any components placed between this source and load. So at any circuits or transmission line, if it is operating at high frequency, due to the transit time effect, there is always going to be a change in the output. So now all components and wires becomes with respect to the distance. So what do we call is distance? So now the distance between the source and load, for example, we'll take L, this is also the length of the transmission line. So when we take the distance, length L, the velocity of the signal becomes length, that is distance divided by time, the time is TR. So when you say at frequency or in terms of time, we prefer always time period is higher, so negligible effect in the output, so the time period is should be greater than the transit time. So if time period is nothing but 1 by frequency and transit time is nothing but, we can rewrite this TR equals to L by velocity. TR is L by velocity, velocity I can break it here. So velocity by frequency is greater than length. By the relations velocity lambda f, I can write velocity by frequency is wavelength. So the wavelength of the signal should be greater than the length of the wire so that transit time effect is negligible. So this is one of the key points we have to take away to use it for high frequency circuit. So whenever the signal frequency wavelength, if we take such a way that it is always greater than the length of the wire, so the transit time effect will be negligible, so I can use it for all the circuit analysis model. So why we have to do it in the circuit analysis? So it will be simpler, I can use that simple current and voltage loss, and I can find out what is a each node or each point of the component, what is the voltage and current. So how to solve this problem at high frequency. So when you take two wire line at high frequency, since the wavelength is now comparable with the length of the wire, I have difference in the voltage and current throughout the transmission line. Due to that, I have a different multiple inductance due to the current carrying conductor, and between the conductor I have a parasitic capacitance is throughout the line it distributed. So normally at high frequency transmission lines are called distributed components, because all the component is distributed with respect to length of the transmission line. So how I can solve this, how I can approach this problem? By making that longer the transmission line into shorter the transmission line. This is called like a sections, uniform sections. Let us take with the length del z. So in this section, what I will assume is the wavelength is greater than length of the transmission line. I'll take a very smaller section such a way that the wavelength of particular section is always greater than the wavelength of the signal. This is particularly greater than the physical length of the section, so that all the transit time effect can be neglected. So I can safely use that circuit principle, and I can find what is the voltage and current for that particular section that can be extended to other section also. So this is what we call from distributed component. If I expand this particular section, so I will get, because of the finite element of the conductor, finite resistance of the conductor, I'll get R, and due to that current carrying, I'll get the inductance. So between the conductor, there is always dielectric loss, and between the conductor, there is always the capacitance. So that finite section, I can expand to the four primary constants, R, resistance and inductance and conductance G and capacitor C. Now the current entering to this section Z, T with respect to distance and with respect to time. I'll take this smaller section is del Z, and the voltage across this wire is V of Z, T. When it comes to the output after the section is Z plus difference with respect to the section, with respect to time, and current with respect to the section and T. So now I can make the smaller section into finite component model. This is called lumped element model. So in this model, all the constants are remain same for particular section. So I can use that safely circuit theory principle here, and I can find out voltage and current for any section of the transmission line. So the distributed component now becomes the lumped element component. So I can use that circuit theory principle. So this is the solution for high frequency transmission line problems, making the distributed components to the lumped element and apply Kirchhoff voltage and current law and find out voltage and current of the transmission line at any point. So it becomes very easier for to use that circuit theory now. And one more important points with respect to primary constant, this R, R, L, G, C with respect to only with respect to the sections. So it's no more like a low frequency circuit where resistance, inductance, conductance and capacitor is constant always throughout the transmission or circuits. So here all the primary constants is only the remains constant only for particular unit length. So R is nothing but resistance per unit section or per unit length. What is the resistance per unit length? That is ohm with respect to meter with respect to section. Similarly, G is a conductance per unit length, that is Henry per meter, and C is a capacitance per unit length, that is farad per meter, and we have this is not string, this is not Henry, it is a Siemens, like Siemens per meter, and I have a H inductance, its inductance per length, that is Henry per meter. And thank you for listening. What the takeaway point from this, from the transmission line, we can make the circuits in the lumped element model, and we can solve this transmission line problem using lumped element. So I can get the voltage and current equations for a distributed transmission line equation. Thank you. Thank you for listening.